안녕하세요, 제림입니다. Hi everyone, welcome to Korean Dream, and this is Jack. The most popular drama in Korea in April and May was Hospital Playlist. If you haven't watched it, check it out. It's very wholesomely fun drama, same production crew as The Reply 1988. So if you are a fan, you would like this drama. This drama has five doctor friends who've been friends since their med school years. So I am wearing white coat, trying to protect Chris's privacy. So today, as you can guess, hospital terms and symptoms, it was too hot, so I took it off. First, let's talk about these fun idioms that we say all the time in Korean, but when you think about the literal meaning, they're really scary. Let's watch this part.
병원. 아, 많이 떨어지는 줄 알았네.
심장 터질 뻔했어.
야, 의사 팀이냐? 벨소리 뭐냐?
아, 야, 넌 그리고 심장 터지는 게 얼마나 무서운 일인데 그런 말을 함부로 하냐?
그럼 넌 애 떨어지는 게 얼마나 슬픈 일인데 함부로 애 떨어진단 말을 해? 넌 보면 진짜 구성애가 없어.
야야, 그만들 좀 해라. 진짜 머리 깨지겠다.
머리가 깨지다니. 너 그럼 죽어.
So let's look at each idiom one by one. 애가 떨어지다. A child or baby drops or falls. That's an idiom that refers to miscarriages. It's used a lot in daily conversations when you're really, really startled and surprised. 애 떨어지겠어. I'm so surprised that my baby's gonna drop. 애 떨어지겠네. Or almost dropped. 애 떨어질 뻔했어. 애 떨어질 뻔했어. 뻔하다 is almost happened, but not quite. And there is 심장이 터지다. 심장 is the organ, heart. 터지다 is to explode. So my heart's gonna explode like a balloon. 심장이 터질 것 같아. 심장이 터질 뻔했어. That's also when you're really surprised, startled, and scared. 머리가 깨지다. 머리 is the head. 깨지다 is to break, but for those that shatter. Whereas when you want to say my bone broke, I broke my arm, I broke my leg, we use 부러지다. 부러지다 you can think about, oh, 부러지다 you can think about something like this, splitting in half, 부러지다. This is our bed we have to assemble. We just moved. And 깨지다 is something like china, ceramics, glasses, and they break. 깨지다. So mirror, 거울이 깨지다. Plates, 그릇, 접시가 깨지다. We use that for skull. So 머리가 깨지다 is when you have headache or when you have so much to think about that it gives you headache and your head feels like it's spinning, it's gonna explode. 머리가 깨질 것 같다. It seems that my head's gonna shatter.
아, 많이 떨어지는 줄 알았네.
심장 터질 뻔했어.
야, 의사 팀이냐? 벨소리 뭐냐?
아, 야, 넌 그리고 심장 터지는 게 얼마나 무서운 일인데 그런 말을 함부로 하냐?
그럼 넌 애 떨어지는 게 얼마나 슬픈 일인데 함부로 애 떨어진단 말을 해? 넌 보면 진짜 구성애가 없어.
야야, 그만들 좀 해라. 진짜 머리 깨지겠다.
머리가 깨지다니. 너 그럼 죽어.
And another one that people use a lot, and from doctor's perspective, hey, don't say that. Let's watch this.
교수님, 빨리빨리 오셔야죠. 배고파 죽겠는데. 너 배고파 죽겠는데. 너 배고파 죽겠는데.
야, 넌 의사라는 사람이 어? 죽는다는 소리가 그렇게 쉽게 나온다, 그지?
Adjective stem 아어, 죽겠다. 죽 is from 죽다, to die. Get here is speaker's intention or speaker's speculation, guessing. So I am guessing I am gonna die. I'm so hungry, I'm so tired that I am gonna die. And people use it a lot. Oh, 배고파 죽겠다. 죽겠다 is the plain speech level, meaning there's no politeness. It's so plain, there's no politeness at all. So when you are almost talking to yourself, you are just reacting to what you feel, you can use it. So people use it a lot between friends.
아, 배고파 죽겠다. 아, 졸려 죽겠다.
Oh, 피곤해 죽겠다. When you go to the doctor, in English, you say you go see a doctor. And when you say hospital, you think about huge medical center. But in Korean, when you go to a doctor's office, a clinic, it's all 병원, hospital. So when you want to say to go see a doctor, you'll say 병원에 가다, to go to a hospital. And I'm back. Doctor, medical doctor is 의사. Nurse is 간호사. This is how they will ask what's wrong with you. 어디가 불편하세요? 어디 literally means where. And 불편하다 is uncomfortable. So where feels uncomfortable? Which part of your body is bothering you? 어디가 불편하세요? Among friends or colleagues, something's wrong with your friend or colleague. What's wrong? You can say 왜 그래요? 왜? Why? 그래요 is 어유와유 form of 그렇다, to be so. Why is it so? Why are you like that? 왜 그래요? What's wrong with your face? 얼굴이 왜 그래요?
얼굴이 왜 그래요? 괜찮아요?
왜요? 전 콜라요.
아니, 너무 많이 부었어요.
야, 응급실 가라, 빨리.
네? 괜찮아요. 그냥 컨디션이 안 좋아서 그래요.
안 괜찮아.
The viewers were shocked to see that scene. 얼굴이 왜 그래요? What's wrong with your face? Are you sick? 어디 아파요? Here, 어디 is not exactly where, but it's more like somewhere. Are you sick somewhere in your body? 어디 아파요? So, the easiest way to say something hurts is something 이 or 가 아프다. 아프다 is to hurt. I have headache. My head hurts. 머리가 아파요. I have stomachache. My stomach hurts. 배가 아파요. For stomach ache, there are different ways to talk about it. And there is a specific phrase that Korean people use a lot, but in English it's not common to say, so I'll introduce that word. 체하다 is to have indigestion. When your stomach's not moving, the food is just sitting there, you can't eat. 체하다. 체했어요. I have a bad indigestion. And when you want to say my stomach doesn't feel right, you just say 속이 안 좋아요. 속 is inside, similar to 안. So my inside is not good. 속이 안 좋아요. And that'll mean my stomach doesn't feel right. My chest hurts. 가슴이 아파요. That can be also used for when you're heartbroken. 가슴이 너무 아파요. And those something 이가 아프다 has Sino-Korean words. Something 통, 통 there is pain. So if you put what has pain, it becomes something ache. 머리, Chinese character, is 두. So 두통 is headache. Teeth or tooth, 치, 치통, toothache. Cramps, 생리, To be in your period is 생리하다. So when you have cramps, 생리통. And then you can say 이 있어요. 두통이 있어요. 치통이 있어요. 생리통이 있어요. So we are looking at words for 증상. There is an important verb when you talk about symptoms. 나다. 나다 is something occurs, something happens, and you do not have control over it. So you use it for the accidents, natural disaster. So 나다 아요어요 form, because the stem ends with 아, with no consonant on the bottom, just like 가, 가다, 가, 나다, 나. And then polite form, 나요. So you use this for body symptoms. 내 피땀눈물. All those three uses 나. 피가 나다, to bleed. 땀이 나다, to sweat. 눈물이 나다, to tear up. Fever, runny nose, sneezing, coughing, all those use 나다. Fever, 열. 열이 나다. 어, 열이 나요. 열 나는 것 같아. I think I have fever. 기침이 나요. 에치, 재채기가 나요. Tear was 눈물, eye water. Runny nose is 콧물, nose water. 콧물이 나요. I have runny nose. How would you say the name of the illness? So for example, I caught a cold. 감기 에 걸리다, to catch a cold. And by the time you say it, you usually already caught it. In English, you also use the past tense. I caught a cold. 감기에 걸리다 becomes 걸려요, 걸렸어요. And you can use it for the flu as well. Flu is severe cold, 독감, 독한 감기. So, 독감에 걸렸어요. And you can use other illness instead of 감기 or 독감. 바이러스, virus right now. 바이러스에 걸리다. You can say it. Cancer, 암에 걸리다. 암에 걸렸어요. Not as serious as that. If you want to say, I have an allergy, allergy is 알레르기. And you can say what kind of 알레르기 it is before 알레르기. So cat allergy, that's me. I have a cat allergy will be 고양이 알레르기가 있어요. I possess that. A lot of people have pollen allergies. Pollen allergy is 꽃가루 알레르기. Pollen is very cute in Korean. 꽃flower, 가루, powder or powdery substance. So pollen, flower powder, cute. Flower powder allergy, 꽃가루 알레르기. And if you have something and that's too severe, you can say 심하다. So you can use 심하다 to be severe with the symptoms or the name of the sickness. If you have allergy, what happens? Something swells, right? To swell up, 붓다. 얼굴이 붓다. 눈이 붓다. 목이 붓다. And 붓다 is one of those irregular short verbs. So when you change to 어유아유 or 으 form, when there is 이응 in the grammar pattern, then short disappears. So instead of 부서요, it becomes 부어요. Instead of 부섰어요, it is 부었어요. So my face is swollen. 얼굴이 부었어요. 눈이 부었어요. My throat swells up. 목이 부어요. My throat's swollen already. 목이 부었어요. So again, in that scene, 얼굴이 왜 그래요? What's up with your face? 많이 부었어요. It's really swollen. And she says, oh, it's just because of cramps. 생리통이에요. So now catch all those. Let's watch that funny scene one more time.
얼굴이 왜 그래요? 괜찮아요?
왜요? 전 콜라요.
아니, 너무 많이 부었어요. 어떻게...
아, 생리통이요. 약 먹었어요.
그럼 약 때문인 것 같은데...
야, 응급실 가라, 빨리.
네? 괜찮아요, 그냥... 컨디션이 안 좋아서 그래요.
안 괜찮아. 알레르기 같은데.
So today I introduced some phrases you can use to discuss the symptoms and illness and all using this drama hospital playlist. And next week I'll come back with the drama The King, Eternal Monarch, and talk about Korean address terms and politeness and so forth. If you like the video, please give me a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe. 안녕히 계세요. 감사합니다.